in reading your book Jaguar Knights, a lot of the time I was just in the story. When I saw you doing a reading of it, I didn't hear you talking. I saw the story going on around me, which to me is the ultimate in a story. If the writer can pull me in that deeply that I forget it's a story, I don't see the pages or I don't hear the author talking, that's what I'm looking for. But while reading it, at one point I started noticing the style and structure you're using in your story, and it was because it was fairly heavy in dialogue, and I thought, well, normally I don't like stories that have this much dialogue and not quite as much action and description. And I realized why it was good was because every writer puts part of themselves into at least some of their characters, and I think the part of you that you put into those characters was you made them good storytellers.
Oh.
So when the dialogue was happening, you weren't thinking, oh, this is detracting from the action. It was part of the action.
That's right. Well, yeah. Thank you. But, there's a rule that a novel should be about half dialogue.
Mm-hmm.
I don't necessarily follow rules. I usually don't discover them until I've been writing books. But the dialogue has to move the story. It's very easy writing dialogue. Think of a beginner problem. You tend to wander off when they're just talking. But it has to move the story, it has to reveal the characters. It doesn't hurt to read a bit of Hemingway.
Mm.
He's badly out of date now, but he has stories that are practically total dialogue.
Mm-hmm.
And you've got to work out what the story is really about by analyzing the dialogue. It's not always obvious.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think that's why I realized I didn't like some stories that I thought were dialogue heavy. It was dialogue that wasn't interesting and had nothing to do with driving the story forward. It was like they stopped the story and talked about tea. And unless tea impacts the story in some interesting way, or unless that conversation about tea is interesting, probably shouldn't be there.
There was a book review by the famous Dr. Samuel Johnson a couple hundred years ago. He said, "Your book is both interesting and original. But the parts that are interesting are not original, and the parts that are original are not interesting."
Oh, burn. Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's the worst I think I've ever read.